Blessed is he whose transgression is forgiven, whose sin is covered. Blessed is the man to whom the Lord does not impute iniquity, and in whose spirit there is no deceit.
When this choir get here? Great job, guys. Great job. I want to take just a moment to welcome everyone to our service this morning. If you are visiting with us for the first time, we would love to have a record of your attendance. And in the back of the seat in front of you, there are some cards. If you would be so kind as to reach and grab one of those, fill it out and drop it in the offering plate, or leave it as you go out the door when the service is over, we would greatly appreciate it. We do have a number of announcements that I want to mention here. First of all, I want to remind you that the Angels Cove Churchwide Shower is Sunday, August the 26th, 1:30, and that'll be over here in the chapel service. So, ladies, we hope you can be a part of that as well. Also, Baptist Children's Home and Family Services, their fall festival is coming up September 15th, 10 o'clock at the Carmi campus. There's going to be booths, crafts, quilt. It's a silent auction. So if you're interested, we would encourage you to be a part of that as well. How many here are seniors? How many will admit being seniors? Anybody over 17 is a senior? I'm kidding. There is going to be a senior adults movie matinee here at the church. It's August the 10th, 2 p.m. at the chapel, and it's going to be a film entitled Paul the Apostle of Christ. Now, it says there are going to be popcorn, candy, drinks, and fellowship, so keep that in mind as well. And then also, the women's ministry is trying to help supply some toys for the daycare, and they're wanting to buy a specific one there. Cost is of the rider is $549, and if you'd like to be a part of that, there are envelopes on the bulletin board, or you can just designate that as you give the offering. Then also, the ladies are still collecting their newborn baby sleepers that they give to mothers who have newborn children. There's a table right outside in the hallway here that you can put those on if you would. And then one last announcement that I want to mention. There is a third annual Neighborhood Watch picnic that's going to take place Saturday, August the 11th. There's free food, drinks, and games. Also, they're going to be giving away backpacks filled with school supplies, so keep that in mind. And they're going to try to give away some bicycles to some of the kids. And I think the thing that I wanted to mention is each one of those bicycles that are going to be given away are going to have a little tag remembering the work that Judy Osborne has done for the Neighborhood Watch. And what we're asking you, if you're interested in donating to buy those bicycles, you can do that. We're going to have some of the men at the doors as you leave. If you want to do that, feel free to do that. But that's coming up on August the 11th, okay? So keep that in mind if you would as well. Prayer request. Carla is with us. Carla, you feeling good? Feeling better? We're grateful she had another scare last week, but God has brought her safely through that, and she is with us today. A number of others that we've been asking for prayer, unspoken requests, so keep those in mind as well. If you would, stand with me, please, and we'll go to the Lord in prayer. And while you're doing that, there is one other thing that I would ask you to be in prayer about. I know that tomorrow evening, the finishing committee is going to be meeting with Bob and the 42nd committee out on the 42nd Street property to kind of go over things and look at the needs and try to get that all kind of narrowed down. But also tomorrow evening at 6 o'clock here at the church, Sugar Camp and their pastor Jesse is going to be coming through, and they're going to be walking our building to look at things. So we're praying that if God is in it, and if God works it out, that we'll be able to transition from this building not only to 42nd Street, but also that Sugar Camp can come into this building and can partake of a ministry that they feel God is leading them to do. So keep that in prayer, if you would, because it's ultimately up to the Lord and His will and what He wants to accomplish. But we're just praying that His will would be accomplished, okay? Father, we come to you today. We say thank you again for your love to us. And we say thank you, Father, for each and every one of these that have come out to be with us here today. We thank you for the privilege in our nation of being able to come out and to gather here as brothers and sisters in Christ. And help us, Father, as we stop and as we pause and as we focus our heart and our mind on you. And Father, as we continue with the worship service today, help us to truly worship you for who you are and what you're doing, and Father, what you've done in our lives. And Father, as we enter into the preaching of your word in the later hour, we just pray that, Father, you would bless in a very special way. And that the words that you would have spoken would be spoken. And that, Father, you might be able to touch hearts and encourage people. And we just thank you and praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Please stay standing as we worship our Lord. First Chronicles, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. We cry out, save us, God. Gather us and deliver us that we may give thanks to your holy name and glory in your praise. I want to give thanks to our Lord this morning, for his love endures forever. So sing with me. Let's lift our voices.
Give thanks to the Lord, our God and King, whose love endures forever. For he is good, he is above all things, his love endures forever.
Love
endures forever, for thy life.
praises to our God, for his love endures forever. And what a great hymn to talk about the assurance we have in our Lord. Blessed assurance, Jesus is ours, Logan Street, and we can rejoice in his goodness. Let's sing this hymn.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine, heir of salvation, virgin of God,
born of his spirit. This morning, for he's our assurance. You may be seated.
Well, it's good to be back this week. I was off on a vacation, but I'm back this week, and I want to have the children come forward for God's crew as they get ready to go. And as they're coming forward, we'll have the ushers come forward as well. We want to remind you that we've talked about the app, we've talked about the giving and things like that. We do have an opportunity on our app, we have an opportunity on our website that you can give as well if you don't happen to have that with you this morning. So we've got some children coming down here. We've got some great singers right behind me right over here on the front. I know they all sing. All right, let's pray together. Father, we just want to thank you for this day. We thank you for these children as they go out to hear about you and hear more about your love for them. And I pray that you'll just speak to their hearts and mold them to grow up in that relationship that you have for them. Father, I pray for our offering this morning that you will use it to bless this church, bless the community, bless the nation. And Lord, just bless the giver as well. And just thank you for how much you love us and how much you give to us and how we can give back to you. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
You were the Word at the beginning, one with God, the Lord Most High. Your hidden run to it and are safe. And there is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven that has been given among men by which we must be saved. Thank you, Jesus, for the hope in your name. How sweet is your name, Lord. How good you are. Silence the boast of sin and
yet a time is coming. It has now come when the true worshipers will worship the Father in the Spirit and in truth. For they are the kind of worshipers that our Father seeks. God is Spirit, and His worshipers must worship in the Spirit and in the truth. I love being able to lift my praises to our Lord and to do it in truth, because that's what He desires from us. We are here to worship this morning. Let's sing together.
Light of the world, You step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see beauty that made this heart adore You. Hope of a life spent with You. Here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that You're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me.
Let's stand together as we worship His name.
King of all days, oh so highly exalted, glorious in heaven above. Humbly You came to the earth You created, all for love's sake He came.
You're all together lovely, all together. glad the Lord is wonderful to us. And we've been saved by our Lord Jesus Christ, by his mercy and his love. Let's sing together.
There is a river of kindness that pours from Emmanuel's veins. The sinner was plunged beneath the flood, and I say,
Heavenly Father, you give us so much. But the greatest thing you give us is our forgiveness. Our chance to live with you forever because you shed your blood on that cross for us. Thank you for undoing us, for breaking us down, for giving us trials so that we can see and know who you are. And the mercy of your gift of grace. I know that sometimes, God, we get overwhelmed and we forget about you. I know sometimes that things are rough in our lives and we forget about you. But I pray, God, that through it all, that we learn to trust in you. We learn to trust in who you are and how you're guiding us. And that through it all, we know that you're standing right beside us. What an incredible promise that is. Thank you for being here in worship with us this morning. In your name we pray. Amen. You may be seated.
I've had questions for tomorrow. There have been times I didn't know right from wrong. But in every situation, God gave blessed consolation that my trials come to only make me strong. I've been to lots of places, and I've seen a lot of faces. There have been times I felt so all alone. But in those lonely hours, yes, those precious lonely hours, Jesus let me know that I was his own. If I never